The following UW360 story is made possible by the generous support of BECU. BECU, more than just money.
My name is Meredith. I'm studying computer science at the University of Washington, and I live in the Toon House.
Hi, I'm Karishma.
I'm Aishu.
I'm studying computer engineering.
I'm studying computer science.
At the University of Washington.
And we live at the Toon House.
The Toon House opened its doors in September 2015. That's the day 8 female UW students literally found a home.
I walked into a room full of girls, and they were all very nice and awesome, and I didn't know what I was in for the rest of the year.
So the Toon House scholarship itself covers rent and it covers groceries. We're also given computers to use.
It also gives the women access to some pretty cool stuff like drones, apps, and other gadgets.
They have so much stuff at their place. It's just awesome, right? That just gives them like the creative spark, right?
The idea for the Toon House came from marketing execs Lee and Lucas Brown. They went to Babson College in Massachusetts and lived in a dorm specifically designed for student entrepreneurs. The brothers co-founded the successful Seattle mobile marketing firm called Toon.
Yeah, after a few years of work building Toon here in Seattle, we certainly began to more realize the gender diversity problem that we even had here at Toon.
I think the issue of the gender gap in tech and the issue of not just gender, but diversity in general, racial diversity, diversity of personalities, it's a big, complicated issue.
So we've certainly seen how diversity can help create an awesome company and an awesome culture. And it's our ability to help lead those discussions.
Today, this scholarship program is facilitating a space for discussion and a community to foster growth.
One thing that we lacked in high school was having a strong community of girls in computer science or in general STEM. And at the Toon House, we have that sort of community here.
Being able to meet like-minded people who are of a similar age and maybe a similar personality and you get along with really well and you feel like you can come to with problems and you can collaborate with, that's an incredibly powerful thing.
They realized that there was
the mentors give residents real-world advice. And the young women get to collaborate on creative projects outside of class.
With my mentor, I'm working on a project, and we're also pairing up with a couple of other girls in the house. We're working on building an app for the house itself, actually.
We're using the smartware technology to develop a device where we can see who the last roomie home is. Like, we call it last roomie home. We want our app to ping you, to remind you to lock the door if you're the last one home. But having a mentor who's actually been through it already is what's really keeping me sane and grounded and looking forward to the future.
I think that they kind of went the extra mile in terms of giving us a place to grow and a place to develop ourselves as like confident women in tech.
This is just the beginning, and so it's a matter of providing a foundation and a framework and a community to inspire people to continue to love technology and study it and want to be a part of it.